one in every flock. Be careful, little one. Little one, be careful. I've never seen anything like that. I've got to take a closer look. You probably have more sense than I have, little one.
When he had climbed to the place, God called to him out of the midst of the fire.
Moses. Moses. Moses.
I'm here. I'm right here.
Take off your shoes, for you are standing on holy ground.
Taken off my shoes. Sir?
I am the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, and the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. I have seen the affliction of my people who are in Egypt, and I have heard their cries, for I know their sorrows. Therefore I will send you, Moses, to free them. And you will bring my people to serve me upon this mountain.
Who am I, Lord, to do this? If I go back to Egypt and say I'm sent by God, nobody will believe me. They'll ask me, what God? What's this God's name? What will I tell them?
I am that I am. You will say, I am has sent me to you. This is my name forever. And they will believe you. Now go. I will be with you.
Lord, they're going to need more than my word.
Moses, cast your staff onto the ground. Now pick it up by the tail. Put your hand inside your robe and draw it out.
My hand, it's diseased.
Put your hand back inside your robe and draw it out again. Show the people these signs, and they will believe. Give them my message, and they will follow you out of Egypt to this mountain, and then you will lead them to their true home, a land that will flow with milk and honey for them all.
Lord, I trust your judgment, but I'm not that great a speaker.
Use your brother Aaron to help you. Do as I have instructed, Moses. I will be with you.
At the very least, we're getting an audience with Pharaoh.
And as was told to me, the Lord God of Israel says, let my people go.
Moses, you expect me to just let the Hebrews leave? Just like that. Because a god I do not know, have never heard of, wants me to? You've been in the desert too long. Look at you. With your tawdry robe and your splintered staff. You're pathetic in my eyes, but then you've always been pathetic. A murderer. A coward. A fraud. As for your Lord God, Pharaoh is the god of Egypt. There is no other.
Show him. Show him the sign.
Behold the power of the Lord God.
Father?
It's just a trick, my son. Watch and see. Even my magicians can outdo your so-called god.
Our magicians are better.
Hear me, Pharaoh. The Lord God has commanded it. Let my people go.
Tell your god that Pharaoh will not release his slaves. They barely work as it is, and you would have me set them free. No. Tell your god that I will increase their work. I will no longer give them straw to make their bricks. They will have to find their own straw. And if they don't meet their quotas, they will die. They will die by day's end. Tell your god that, Moses.
To them.
God has spoken to me. This day is the beginning of your journey to the Promised Land. Tonight, you must eat nothing but unleavened bread and the meat of lamb. Let each of you take the blood of the lamb and mark your doors, and don't leave your homes until morning. For tonight, the Lord God will come, and he will deal with your oppressors and will shield you from the destroyer. When death sees the mark of lamb's blood on your doors, he will pass over your homes. He will not hurt any of you. But once we leave this land, you must remember and celebrate this night. This night of the Passover.
And the people did as the Lord commanded.
Just passed us by.
Thank God.
Yes. But pity the firstborn of Egypt.
And at midnight it came to pass, as Moses said, all the firstborn of Egypt were struck. There was not a house where there was not one dead. And a great cry rose up.
God, Ra! No! Not my son! Not my son! Find Moses! Get me Moses! Moses! Moses!
And where are we going?
We go to the Promised Land.
Where is this Promised Land?
I don't know.
No map to guide us?
No.
Then how?
He will guide us. I have faith that he will lead the way.
And the Lord went before them as a pillar of cloud to lead the way by day, and by night, a pillar of fire.
Come on! This way!
The fire.
Moses, you cannot stop me. You will die at my hands.
Egyptians you see today, you will never see again. See how the Lord protects you.
Shall we go?
Yes, sister.
Come, children. Hurry, hurry!
Don't forget the wagon!
She wanted to see the fish.
Pharaoh's army! They're coming!
I told you they'd kill us. Didn't I tell you? They'll kill us all, thanks to you.
Behold the salvation of the Lord!
So Moses brought Israel through the wilderness. They went many days and found no water. The people began to doubt.
What kind of trip is this? No food, no water?
You want to kill us? Is that the idea?
What kind of man are you?
Do you have any idea what you're doing?
You complain. You always complain. Hasn't God taken care of you like a father does his children? Hasn't he promised you a great land to call your home? A land of water, of green valleys and hills? Hasn't he promised you all of this?
But we're hungry
and thirsty.
Really thirsty.
Are we there yet?
And the people wept all that night, crying.
Moses, we're thirsty!
Moses, we're hungry!
Why have you and God taken us to this horrible place?
Now, at least the Egyptians fed us
and gave us water.
I have an idea. Let's go back. If God really talks to you, tell him we're dying out here.
My wife's not happy, that's for certain.
Didn't you do anything?
If God provides you water, will you stop whining?
Well, yes, but there's no water around here.
See how God loves you.
While you're at it, we could use some food. Got any ideas?
Lord, these people are driving me mad. I just don't understand what you want me to do. I'd appreciate your help.
I have heard the murmurings of Israel. Come morning, I will rain food from the heavens for you. Speak to them and say so.
Children of Israel, God has heard your cries. Tomorrow morning, you will see.
Mother, father, come look.
And in the morning it was so. On the ground lay food, like the frost.
This is the bread the Lord has given you. It is manna, bread from heaven. Take it, eat it. Let your stomachs be full. Thank you, Lord.
Like honey.
Eat. Eat and let's march.
How much further, my brother?
That way. Towards that mountain.
As God knows it.
Go ahead.
Well, why hasn't God given us any meat?
All we get is manna. Manna, manna, manna. The Egyptians gave us meat.
We have fish and cucumbers and melons.
Cucumbers and melons aren't meat.
I meant beef and lamb.
We always had beef and lamb.
Yeah.
We did?
We had a wide variety of foods to choose from.
I mean, let's face it, a little manna goes a long way.
Why, I couldn't have put it any better myself.
But you told us what to say.
Lord, what can I do with these people? I can't take it anymore. All day long, all night long, what do I hear? Give me this, give me that. Give me bread, give me water, give me meat. Lord, there is no meat out here.
Is my power doubted? Go and tell them they shall have food.
Thank you, Lord. I have spoken to the Lord. He will give you meat, not just for one day or 10 days, but for a whole month, until it comes out of your ears, because you questioned why you were led out of Egypt. Enjoy your meal. Joshua, my young general.
I merely fight for God, Moses. I'm no general.
Come, sit by me, boy. One day, a general you will be. God has told me you will do great things for our people.
Really?
God tells me many things.
Well, thank you, Moses. Well, thank you, sir.
Would you tell Aaron and Miriam I'd like to speak with them?
Yes, sir.
You sent for us?
Sit, brother and sister, sit. You both seem troubled.
Moses, you promised too much.
Don't worry. Everything will be fine.
I know you think God only speaks to you, but he speaks to us too. I never heard him mention anything about meat.
If you were able to empty all the seas of all the fish, there still wouldn't be enough to feed all of our people.
Once you both believed.
Hear now my words, my children. I speak to everyone who believes in me, but to Moses I make myself known. I chose Moses as my servant among all, for he is the most humble man on earth. So to Moses I speak face to face.
Never forget God's plan.
Quail! Out here?
They are here because God said they'd be.
Look! The meat!
Come on. I hope you like quail. You'll be getting a lot of it for the next month. Me? I don't like quail all that much.
Strange place.
Place the Lord first appeared to me.
Moses.
God wants me there again.
I'm afraid.
Don't be. Come. Come, we'll make camp here. Voice of God, do not be fearful. One day, you will all be able to open your hearts to his voice. Now, I must go up on the mountain and talk with God.
Be careful, Moses.
I am with God. Watch over our people. They may grow restless.
I will.
I'm coming with you.
Now I feel safer. Joshua, I must go alone from here.
I'll wait for you, Moses.
And he climbed up into the thick cloud where God was. He stayed 40 days and 40 nights. Darkness covering the glory.
Moses. Moses, I give to you the way to live. I give to you my Ten Commandments. Remember them. Teach them. Teach them for the rest of time. Your God, you shall have no other gods before me. You shall not worship false gods. You shall never take my name in vain. You shall keep the Sabbath day holy. Honor your father and your mother. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not lie. You shall never want what belongs to others.
Someone's attacking the camp.
It's not war we hear. It's a celebration. Too far this time.
It's Moses!
Moses!
So it's Moses. We don't need him anymore. We have our own God, right here. Look, it sparkles. You see how it sparkles? It's gold. Gold, gold!
Moses.
Thank God.
This is how you repay the Lord? He brought you out of slavery. He led you across the desert. He parted the seas to let you live. And yet, you doubted him. I call on heaven and earth to see what you have done.
Oh, what are you afraid of? A little bad weather? We could use some rain, right? Right? I mean, it's dry out here.
Don't you realize he loves you? He gave these to us. His commandments. All who believe in the Lord
all who are on his side. Come to him. Walk towards me.
Yes.
Well, are you people crazy? We have a golden god right here. All Moses has is a couple of rocks. Rocks! Well, you can find rocks anywhere. He says those rocks are God's laws. They're Moses' laws. Moses wants to be like Pharaoh. Well, he thinks he's better than everybody else.
Today, you will witness the judgment of the Lord. Forgive them. They're sorry. If you're still angry, if you want to punish anyone, punish me first.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.